What's going on, dudes? Welcome back today. And we have some stuff to talk about. Updates with Black Ops 3, things that I've been doing. And I wanted to make a video that's just a little bit more, what's the best word for it? I guess fun? I've been pretty crabby lately because I've been doing Dark Matter. LMGs were my last one I've done lately for Diamond. And we just finished yesterday, which is awesome. We still have two launchers left and a knife, and then we're done completely. But I wanted to just like get in a better mood. It's way more fun to play when I have a chance at doing decent with these kind of guns instead of getting destroyed. We still have to deal with teammates, but you know, that's a constant in the game. Anyways, updates. If you haven't noticed, Exodus is... I'm getting aim... Here we go, aim assist. Aim assist. I was like, where is he? Exodus is back in Black Ops 3, if you didn't know. It was taken out in the PS4 version because it was causing the game to crash, so it was removed for a while from all game modes, not just S&D, from all game modes, and it's been recently re-added with the update that happened a few days ago. Also, with that update, a few other changes may have happened that you might not know about. So, if you didn't know, I'm using Awareness right now. Awareness did receive a nerf, which is awesome. Unfortunately, it was the wrong type of nerf. Okay, a knife was just trying to ninja defuse or something. It was the wrong type of nerf. I guess to say that, Awareness is really good at hearing people just because of how strong of a perk it is and how... Okay, I'm just gonna get on the other side of the turtle. Hopefully he didn't see me. Oh, he did now. Okay, he has a 48 dredge. If I just stay close range, he won't be able to kill me that well. That gun has a long burst delay. Or shots between, I guess, time between bursts. I can wait it out. But to continue... There we go. But to continue, Awareness no longer hears people as effectively at a distance, like you can't hear them as far away, but it's still the same strength of sound whoring within the range that they're in. So, you can hear people at dead silence just as easily because they're close to you. It doesn't really change the fact that it counters dead silence too easily, and that was the problem with Awareness. So I think that they need to reverse it, leave it how it was before, but make it less strong, or make dead silence more dead silent, and that would be a better fix, in my opinion, to what is what I consider unbalanced. If you did not know, the Weevil received a buff recently, and I'm not sure what exactly was buffed with it, other than, I think the range of the gun, or maybe a lower recoil with it. I forget exactly, that's why we're using it right now, we're testing it out. It seems to be working okay, but keep in mind these guys are using knives. So, I mean, gun versus knife, what usually wins, right? On top of that, another really important update that you guys might not have noticed, I'm using the Spectre with Psychosis. The Spectre, as I mentioned in the past, has the quietest footsteps in the game. And there was no reason behind it, right? He's a robot. If there was anyone, if there was any specialist that was going to get that kind of bonus perk, you think it would be the Reaper. Or no, we're not using Spectre, I'm sorry, we're using Reaper with Psychosis. You would think it'd be the Spectre that would have got the silenced footsteps because he's an assassin, you know? Like assassins would have quieter footsteps, or ninjas, kind of. A robot, not so much. We're using the Reaper. I'm sorry, I got you guys confused there. We're using Reaper with Psychosis. The Reaper had the quietest footsteps for some reason. And in the patch, they made him just as loud as everyone else now. So he's no longer the quietest specialist. No one is. They all have the same audible level of footsteps. So, if you were using that for that reason, you can get rid of it. He no longer has his... And I think Hutch referred to it as built-in dead silence, which was pretty much what it was. And it was nice. It was pretty good. I'm going to throw a stun over that. And then I'm also going to do something here if you guys haven't seen this. It's only a few more seconds. The Hellstorm got a buff as well, along with a lot of other killstreaks. But the Hellstorm's the only important one, in my opinion, for S&D. They increased the lock-on range of it when you shoot it, which is really good. They also increased the speed at which it flies down from the sky, so it's harder to avoid, which is really useful. Both things will make the Hellstorm probably effective enough to replace the HC car in Search and Destroy. If you guys didn't know for a long time, the Hellstorms and the Lightning Strikes were both awful, really bad. And because of that, I never used them. I instead would always prefer the HC, UAV, and then Sentry Gun. So now I'm using Hellstorm, Sentry, and UAV instead, And I think it's been a bit more effective. It's been way more useful. The Hellstorm before, man, was absolute crap. It was absolute crap, which sucked because if you look at past games, Hellstorm missiles, Predator missiles, whatever it was, they were pretty damn good. Like almost always a staple in Search and Destroy. Everyone would run UAV, Predator, Hellstorm. Like that was the good combo. And it changed. That's all we can say is it changed. It was not good anymore. So it's getting back to its glory days. So you might want to consider throwing that on. I'm not sure about Lightning Strike still, especially because the Lightning Strike, when you call it in, it gives the enemy team a heads up. It says like enemy Lightning Strike inbound or something. Or it lets them know that you're calling it in before you actually call it in, which kind of defeats the purpose of surprising someone and I guess catching them off guard. So I don't know. Okay, let me see. I didn't see anyone there. That's weird. No one found me that way. Maybe they're back here? AFK-er? Save me, Sentry. Thank you. Glad I did that. Let's just face it this way. In case one of them comes back to their spawn, that'll find them. No point in dragging that along with me the whole time. Oh, he got him. There's an assist. I feel like it's lagging a little bit. Also, I wanted to mention one thing, because a lot of people have been talking about this and asked me personally. They're like, Marksman, what about this dead silence, or what about this, I'm sorry, not dead silence, what about this skill-based matchmaking? Like skill-based matchmaking's in the game. I keep finding lobbies of all these good players. I don't think that's true. I've found plenty of lobbies that are against plenty of bad players. I think what you're experiencing, is he in the corner again? No. Whoa, yeah, okay, it is lagging. I think what you're experiencing, someone told this or saw this on Twitter, is that, I think it was Vonderhaar actually, that when you guys buy DLC, only like the players that are really interested in playing the game a lot buy DLC, right? Casual people don't really buy it too often. So they try to match you against other people that buy DLC simply because they want you to play the new maps, which makes sense, right? Like, duh. But also at the same time, where is this guy? Oh, there he is. I didn't know where the hell he was. I've never seen someone in that corner in my life. So you're playing against better people because the better people buy DLC, or the higher level skill players buy DLC, and that makes it so you find those people more often. If you'd like to avoid that, which you can, delete the DLC or uninstall it. You have to install the whole update, but even with installing the whole update, you do not have to download the maps, if that makes sense. You can uninstall the update, reinstall it, and then do not download the maps. Don't go in and say, you know, use this, purchase, whatever. And you should stay without the maps, and then you can play against easier people, if you really have to. I prefer the new maps, that's my style, it's more fun for me. So I'm gonna stay with that, but if you guys really want it, you can. Not a bad game though, 15-0 with the Weevil, pretty damn good. Weevil seems okay, I don't know. I think it's because we're just playing kniving people, knivers, but yeah, the Vesper is still the number one class, in the, or number one SMG in the class. The number two, number three are tied between the VMP and the CUDA. If you want to use those are both really good guns as well. Hope you guys enjoyed though. I'll see you later. Hopefully this was a more fun commentary, more happy. Again, it's hard to be negative, I guess, if I go 15-0. But I think it covered everything that I wanted to between the new update for Search and Destroy. Most of the important things that you would probably have an impact from, I mentioned. If there's any other questions, though, leave a comment, of course, and I will talk to you guys later.